Hey everybody, Dirty Dan here. Well, today we're going to be starting the restoration on this vintage 040 Aristocraft Camelback made around 1964-ish. I found that out in a very old model railroading book I have. But yeah, this thing has been awaiting a restoration for about a year now. I've never got around to it. The only thing I know I could tell you guys I did to it is I did make a drawbar for it. Just a little thing out of plastic. And I added a screw for the tender so I could actually pull some cars. I actually just did that the other day just to prepare for the restoration. Here's some parts. It needs a lot of love. And if I get this thing up close to the camera, you'll really see how dirty this thing is. We're not going to touch it up or clean it up. I mean, well, we're not going to touch it up or anything. We are going to clean it up, though. Like this cylinder over here, that has a bit of corrosion on it. Just, basically a full restoration, but we're not going to be repainting anything because I like to leave these things original. So in this part, we're going to be disassembling this thing. Now I'm going to do this in parts because, you know, this is not something I normally do. I normally do time-lapse restorations. I'm kind of known for that, but I figured, hey, you know what? We'll try something different this time because I figured, you know, why not just do an SMT style restoration? But because this takes so long, and I'm not just really maintenancing the thing, SMT is a little bit of a different style, that's why he can do this. So I'm going to have to split it up into parts, because this is going to be disassembly, the next one's going to be cleaning and repairs, and then the last one is going to be reassembly. So, there we go, we got our first part off. Now, I think what the next thing we want to do is probably take off this tender. There's just this simple little screw right there on the tender that comes right out, and that should release. Yep, there we go. We got our tender disassembled. So the tender is going to be probably a next part. There's not much to disassemble here. Pretty simple. Probably just put some oil on the wheels. We're gonna have to figure out what's going on with this because these trucks are not put together very well. So we're gonna try to see if we can fix that. But anyways, let's start our disassembling our engine here. Now it looks like this big screw right here is how this whole thing comes apart. So let's just take that big screw out. Now, I've not taken this thing apart before. Oh, it looks like the stack is actually threaded. So let's get this screw out, and then that should release our body. I think this should let the thing come apart. There's our stack, and then let's just gently lift this thing up. Okay, no, something is still holding it in. Oh, I see. Right there. Got a little screw down in that hole. Right there. Let's get that screw out. There we go. Now, we got to be careful because this thing is made out of zinc and brass. It's very fragile. Okay, there is our... Whoa! That motor is old! Oh, man. Okay, here. Let's not lose any parts. Okay. So for the back here, we had a little washer on there. Oh, and here comes the rain, guys. Thunderstorm coming. So this is going to be kind of like an ASMR restoration almost. Wow, that is cool. I have never seen a motor of that design or shape or anything. That is really awesome. Let's just get our thumbnail right here. Boom. But yeah, wow. That is really cool. That is just amazing. Look at that. It's amazing what motors used to look like, you know. But okay, let's take a look at our body. Everything on here is in pretty good shape. We're only missing one of these cylinders. That's all that I know is missing off of this thing. So that was a I don't exactly remember what I got this thing for. I think it was around $15, which I think is a pretty good price. We got to be real careful with this thing. We don't want to be losing anything other parts off of it. You can see it's got its windshield up in there. I don't think any of these other parts need to come off, so I think we'll just leave those. But the shell is in pretty good shape. Yeah, that's just a big piece of grime right there. All right, well, let's see what we can do about our frame here. I've never taken one of these apart, so let's take off this cover right here. Let's see what's underneath this cover. I'm gonna assume this is probably the gearbox, but I don't think there's much of a gearbox. I think it's literally just a worm gear and a gear on the axle. That is how it's driven. I can't guarantee that. Okay, we might need all right, there we go. We got our back screw and our front screw. Make sure these are the same. Yes, they're exactly the same, so we can mix these up. Okay, so now we should be able to get this thing to release. Let me get a knife to try to pry this off, because yet again, we need to be very gentle with this. There we go. I don't know if you guys just saw that, but that was like release. Okay, let's gently take this cover off. Wow. That's not as bad as I thought. Somebody is definitely taking care of this thing, so we don't really have to... There's not much here that needs to be cleaned, actually. This looks pretty good. Okay, now I think these wheel sets should just... Awesome! Look at that. They come right out. Okay. Right, so, next thing we need to do. This motor needs to probably come out. So let's... I'm assuming it's this screw in the front and a screw right there on the back. So let's remove these screws, and this motor should pop right out. That one is not loosening all the way, so I don't know if that's stripped out or something. But it is always an interesting experiencing, getting to see what these locomotives, you know, how they used to be built. It's always fun. You know, that's what I really enjoy about this hobby. Alright, so we need to desolder that wire. Let me get my trusty soldering iron hooked up. But, yeah, well, let's take a look. Just while that's heating up, let's take a look at our wheels. Now, I don't know, yeah, I think we might take these rods off. Yeah, they don't look too complicated. And then, you see, we gotta clean all this grime off of there. I think we ought to just use some isopropyl alcohol and maybe just soak these guys, because that would probably be the best solution. Now, you can see, you can just tell how old this thing, just by is the insulation on these wheels. You can see it, like, sticking out. That's very interesting. But, I mean, look at the grease on there. I mean, this thing was definitely taken care of. So, and by the way, this thing does run, which is beyond me. I always thought that was amazing that this thing still ran. But now seeing the inside, I'm not very surprised. All right, let's get this wire right here unsoldered. Let's just get our soldering iron right in there. And, oops, I accidentally soldered it back on. And there we go. Comes right off. Okay. Now, let's put that back. Turn that off. And boom, there we go. Wow, those contacts are really dirty. Look at the hair on that one. Jeez. If my camera would focus. Yeah, that's pretty bad. My stomach just growled. Okay, yeah, these screws are different, so we need to put these back. Exactly in the holes. I think I'm just gonna put them back like that, just so I don't forget exactly how they go in there. Okay, there we go. Let's get this back one in. You know, for some reason, I've always liked doing restorations in the storms. You know, it really helps me work. All right, so that's a little bit oily. We're gonna have to get all that oily residue off there. Ooh, look at it on my finger. Wipe off my finger. Okay, well, I don't know exactly. I think this is actually soldered together. This motor, I mean, I don't think we're gonna have to disassemble this thing too much. There's not much to disassemble here. I think what we're gonna do is clean off that commutator. That is one thing we need to do. It's not even that dirty, to be honest. Oh, there's some crap. There's some junk in between those little fins. between the contacts. It's a very important step. You can never skip this. You know, I would have thought this would have been a lot more worn, you know? But, well, there we go. Well, that's about it for all the disassembly. Oh, actually, we did forget one thing. We need to get this, actually, I don't know. I think these cylinders are a different part. Oh, yes, they are. Okay, we got those off. Alright, so let's get this contact off of here. I think it's just this screw right here. Okay, there we go. Awesome, but just, wow. Jeez, that's really bad. Come on, focus. Yeah, that's all hair. So we're gonna have to get all that oil off of there. But that is why we have our tool called an ultrasonic cleaner. Now, you guys are gonna learn a lot about that thing in this series, because that thing we're gonna need to use quite a few times. But, yeah. So, another thing is, people are saying that this thing is kind of a miracle because it's made completely out of zinc and there's no rot or anything. If you look these up, if you look up Aristocraft HO Scale 040, you'll probably find one just like this. And you'll see, if you look, you'll see some of the ones that, this entire cab right here, that's made out of zinc. So these things are just self-destruct. But this one was okay. So I think this is a really good purchase. But I hope you guys enjoyed this part. And next part, we're going to be taking all these parts, cleaning them, and repairing any small things that we need to do. And I think I'm going to leave these together. So that will be fine, because we don't really need to take that apart. But anyways, guys, I'll see you next time.